So what do you do when you've got loads and loads of vehicles to plan deliveries and pickups and you're trying to do it on a whiteboard? It's a nightmare. What do you reckon, Jas? What's the way around it?
It's a route optimization tool.
A route optimization tool. What's one of those? Where do you get one? And what does it do for you? That's the topic for this week. Okay, Jas, so you work with a company called PTV and you have a tool that helps people actually schedule their routes.
Yeah, Rob, that's correct. We have a tool called PTV Route Optimiser, and it's a tool really designed for companies that have a larger fleet, although it works on smaller fleets as well, but typically, you know, you have 15 or 20 more vehicles and multi-drops, it can become quite a challenge.
So look, I've used a lot of these different tools over the last 20 or 30 years.
Yeah.
I have to say there's a motive for talking to Jas today, because we actually use the PTV tool, Route Optimiser, in our consulting work. So we're doing a lot of this, you know, sort of fleet size and mix study and so on for our consulting clients. So I think it's a really neat tool. But one of the reasons that we're talking to Jas today is that we actually want to see a tool like this in action. So tell us where we are today, Jas.
Well, we're at ANC. ANC delivers, and they're a big logistics service provider. They do a lot of the home deliveries for the big retailers in Australia, and they've implemented Route Optimiser to assist their schedulers with their growing task. So they currently run a fleet of about 150 vehicles on Route Optimiser among six dispatchers.
So you reckon we can go and have a chat to them and have a look around?
And
in fact, the people behind us, I think, are actually doing the routing, aren't they? Maybe we're going to have a talk to them as well.
Absolutely.
And we'll get a real hands-on feel for how these tools are used and the sort of benefits that people can get from them.
And how that works operationally. Because that's a big difference between using a tool strategically and getting it to work operationally.
That's a nice little dig there, mate. Using it strategically as a consultant or hands-on operationally. No, that's very true. So let's get around and talk to some of the people at ANC. Now let me introduce Lucy, who's the IT manager at ANC. Lucy, Jas was telling us about how you've implemented the route scheduling software.
Mm-hmm.
Love to hear about, you know, some of the benefits, and maybe you can tell us about the changes. What was it like before the software tool and after?
So before, a lot more people doing the same work, and then after we've implemented it, we've reduced a couple of shifts, but a lot more work has come through. So we've been able to consistently route the work and get more work out to the drivers with less staff inside.
Excellent.
Yes.
So the productivity has increased of the drivers and of the people planning, and you're taking on a lot more work.
Yes.
That's awesome. Yes. What was the implementation of all of that like? Was that quite tricky from going a manual process to automated?
No, it wasn't too tricky. Understanding what the system can and can't do is always just a learning curve. But once it was set up and the guys are actually using it to route, it's pretty simple.
Right.
It's got great messages and good visuals on it too.
So it's obviously helped you enormously within the business. Mm-hmm. Have you noticed any sort of feedback from customers?
The customers, not so much for me, but I have heard there's less issues being raised.
Okay.
So we've got more volume of work, and in routing through it, there's less issues that are raised. So we're sort of getting it right. We have actually been able to easily implement a reduction of delivery window for the customer after routing.
That's so good. Yeah. Now that's interesting, because one of the things, or I guess one of the levers in terms of scheduling vehicles, is the delivery time windows.
Yes.
And always, if you're trying to get, you know, more productive work done with your transport fleets, the best thing to do is to try and ease out those delivery time windows. So if you've got customers who say, look, we need to deliver between 9 and 10, if you can get them to say, look, any time between 9 and 11, that gives you a lot more flexibility to actually do your scheduling and make it all more efficient. So Lucy, what you're saying is it's become so efficient you can actually tighten those windows.
Yeah.
So you can be a lot more specific for the customers.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Yeah. And just tell them the night before.
Yeah.
We've told you all day beforehand, and now the night before, actually it's this small window, and they appreciate that a lot.
Great. Yeah. So what's the next step?
More customers.
Yeah.
More states rolling it out further. Yeah.
Great. So the system has actually helped you just take on a lot more volume.
Yes.
Great.
Yeah. And consistent, gives us a nice consistency with stuff. Yeah.
Do you reckon we could? There's a lot of people using the system downstairs. Do you reckon we could go down and talk to them and see what the users think of it?
Sure.
Let's go downstairs.
Okay, so what's going on here, Lucy?
Okay, well, here's Mitch. He's actually allocating some work and keeping track of the drivers throughout the day for the transport management system, and he will also call and talk to the drivers when they've come up with some issues too.
Excellent. And I noticed we've got this board up on the wall. What's this about?
Oh, that's for our call centre, because we've got incoming call queues, and we also have this board over here, which shows us just a quick snapshot of what our drivers are throughout the day.
Very good. So that's all based on what's there.
Now, let's get down to the action end and see how this system actually works. We've got Marco with us.
Hello.
Buenos dias, Marco.
¿Qué tal? Buenos dias.
Should we do this in English or Spanish?
Let's keep it in English.
Keep it in English, okay, for the viewers. So, you're actually helping people train how to use this system. So, it goes, what do you call it, Route Optimiser?
Route Optimiser PTV, yes.
Great. So, tell us what's on these. You've got three screens. Tell us what's on here.
So, basically on this left screen, I don't know if you can see it there.
Oh, yeah.
But this is the access database.
Yeah.
This is like the filter before the jobs go across into PTV.
Yeah.
So it's basically just a tool in order to get the data cleaner.
Yeah.
So we can see the jobs here in the map, and have a street level. So it's not only the suburb, so we can go really into the street, which is what we want.
And this, we see the route actually building up.
Here. Yeah, the route, for example, this one starts in Blacktown and it just go all the way to the inner west, finishing in Haverfield, Ashfield.
And then on the center screen, we've actually got sort of the listing of the drops, yeah?
Yeah, so we have the driver, for example, this driver number 543, and we have here the job numbers. So. With this client, we have two different services, which is HDD and HDS, which mean one of them is a deluxe delivery, which means the driver will have to go in, install it, test it, and
So does the system take account of that? So, you know, where it's an install, the system knows to leave more
time? So in the database, we set up some small rules based on the service code. So. If it's a drop, it will say HDS, which will give less amount of time. For example, we can see that this driver, this is one of the fastest drivers that we have in the fleet.
Okay.
So this guy, for example, for a drop off, which is an HDS, he will take about 6 minutes. And for an HDD, he will take about 11 minutes to get the appliance out of the car, out of the truck, getting into the customers. Yeah, that is
We're talking washing machines and things like this?
Washing machines, fridges, yes, correct.
Can I get him to install my next one? That's pretty quick.
We can arrange it.
Yeah. So tell me, what was life like prior to having a system like this? How would you do something like this manually?
Well, we would have basically a map and full of dots, and we would say, well, this guy, we're guesstimating that can do this amount of deliveries and in this amount of time. So it was a lot of guesstimating there. But with this tool and based on the historical data that we have, we can see at what time the driver is getting into the address, what time he's completing the job. And we just grab big amounts of data and we just go through it and we calculate the times that they take.
Okay, so let me simplistically try to play back what we're doing here. So you get all of your orders into the system, which was on that screen but was over here.
Yep.
Yeah, and then we dump them into PTV. How many orders would you be putting in here on a day?
At the moment, this is just only one client, which is...
Yeah, so this is a training setup.
Yeah, for today, there were 135 jobs.
Yeah, really good. So the guys who are scheduling out here, I mean, this is the training room. How many drops would they be scheduling every day?
It's around throughout the whole day, it's around 500, 600.
Wow, you wouldn't want to do that manually.
So this is the first thing how we see the orders.
Yeah, and these are what, pickups and deliveries?
Yeah. With this specific client, we got a different thing, which is, we call it transport jobs in PTV, which is a pickup from one store. Yeah. For example, this one is a pickup from Castle Hill and it goes to Beaumont Hill. So this implies we have a central warehouse.
Yeah.
And then the same driver that delivers this job will have to go to Castle Hill first.
Yeah.
pick up the rest of the order and take it to the customer.
And so this is happening daily?
On a daily basis,
The system allows you to, if the customer says, I don't want that delivery now, you can actually go in dynamically and change it, can't you?
Yeah, we just, we will have to identify which customers will like this service, and we can change, for example, this order. We can just go into a specific order and assign a specific time.
So if someone came along to you and said, would you like to use a tool like this for all the scheduling or to do dots on a map?
I would prefer 100 times this one. It's just, it makes it quicker, it makes it better. For a COR perspective, chain of responsibility.
That's a really good point.
This is great because it just makes you, it gives you a certainty that you're not gonna run a driver for more than 12 hours.
So you manage the hours.
You're gonna give them breaks throughout the day. And we can see here, for example, the break time in every run. If the run goes over 10 hours, it has to assign an hour break.
Yeah. Thanks for showing us around the system, Marco.
No worries.
Muchas gracias.
Ah, de nada.
So I thought before we leave ANC, we ought to talk to the boss. James, thank you very much for letting us have a look around.
Pleasure indeed.
What an amazing business. You're doing all kinds of delivery operations, aren't you?
We are indeed, yeah. Well, we do a lot of deliveries per month.
And what sort of clients are you looking after?
A lot of retail clients, IKEA, Bunnings, JB Hi-Fi, The Good Guys, those sort of people.
And we were downstairs talking to Marco and he was explaining how a lot of it's home delivery and installs and all that
kind of
stuff.
It is, yeah. So very complex when you walk into a home.
I bet. He was telling me how one guy can install a washing machine or something in 11 minutes. That's amazing.
It takes me 3 days.
Yeah, that's right. So I guess, look, we've been having a look at route scheduling systems and the benefits that they give to businesses. Maybe just to finish off with yourself, what was life like before having a scheduling tool like this versus life after?
So there's two really big benefits. The first one is really just consistency. Mm. So now we're getting consistency in terms of the allocation and the runs and the work being performed. So you get a better customer experience.
Yeah.
But also too, then there's great benefits for the contractors, the drivers.
Yeah.
So less mileage, less fuel consumption, shorter hours. So fatigue is less of a problem, safety.
Yeah.
And then from a cost perspective, they're making more money because they're not burning as much fuel. So win-win all around.
Yeah. I mean, I think, to be honest, anyone who's trying to manage a fleet of more than sort of 20, 25 vehicles without a system like this, it would be a struggle. I can't imagine. You're running, what, 150 or something?
800.
800?
Well, we've got 800 vehicles nationally.
Wow.
Through the system. I think it's about 150, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, so... That's amazing. So I just want to thank you again. We'll put a link below to ANC so that people know who we've been visiting today. Your team have been great.
Thank you very much.
The enthusiasm and using the system and
so on. They're a good crew.
And stepping us through it. Thank you very much.
Pleasure indeed.
So there we go. A quick look at route scheduling software. And thank you again to ANC for hosting us. And showing us around the business and how they use the software. Thank you, Yael Specker, of course.
Pleasure,
from
Rob.
PTV, who provide the systems. Great system, I have to say that, because we use it for our consulting work. Now, you remember how this works. If you enjoyed the video, do subscribe. Make sure you get our weekly videos. They come out on a Wednesday. If you have any comments, do comment below, and I'd love to help you answer questions that you have about fleet management. And look, let's put a couple of links below as well. So we'll put a link to PTV, and a link down to ANC based here in Sydney, who've been our host today. So thank you for watching. Look forward to talking to you again next week. And if you've got any questions, comment below.